Welcome to the third episode of my GTA Online Restart, and in this one we start out with some ballers. So, all the cars you see here are ballers. So the two behind me are the newer model, this one is the older one. They don't really, yeah, I mean they don't look like too much the, well, they share the color in this case. But they are pretty easy to identify by the air intakes or outlets on the front fender. So, yeah, both of them go for 9K, just so you know. As I mentioned, if I see any of those cars, I will just point it out to you. But yeah, now it's time to finally get into jobs and get some real money. We're just not relies on us selling one car every 48 minutes, because, well, as I mentioned, a nice little add-on if you can just do it, but as it is, it's not a viable thing to just wait for the rest of the time. So, to get into jobs, there are two or three main ways. You can host one, you can join one specifically, or you can go for a random job. So, yeah, joining right now, I am only invited to a job that I would likely have to host. If it comes up from one of the NPCs, just forget about it. There are some real invites that can be looked at here. Usually, right now, nothing comes up. But we can always just go for a quick job and play whatever we want here. So one thing is important when it comes to this, or a few things really. Doomsday Heist, very difficult, doesn't really pay that well. So forget about that. Most of the things can have double money and experience. Stuff like Arena Wars is very pay to win heavy, so without having a vehicle, not always worth getting into that, but it might be fun, and if a host only use stock vehicles, it could be okay. So right now we have triple money and RP on the SA Super Sport Series, so we are going to do some of it. And yeah, to keep up to date with that, you can follow some people on Twitter who point out some of the stuff, and you could also just take a look at the roster news via or some dedicated YouTube channels who make constantly some updates to that. Most of the events last for 1 week or two, so yeah. There is a set cycle for that, usually resets every Thursday. So right now we have a Hot Wing Race, which will be triple money and RP for this week, but there are only three people in there, so doesn't really work out. In races and such, there are three main factors that determine how much money you will get in the end. First up, of course, your position that you finish in. And as I mentioned, since I am quite adept at racing, going for races is definitely something for me. So I can likely do I can likely get a decent position here. The second thing is the total amount of people in there, which is why I quit that job. 3 out of 30 isn't great. If you have more like 16 or so, suddenly the payouts for the top places become more interesting. And the third is the amount of time you spend in the race. Every minute you get a higher payout. So if you have like 1 minute 57, it will be the same payout as for 1 minute 59 if you have the same place in the end. But 2 minutes and 1 second suddenly gives you a bit more money, and that goes up until 8 minutes, so everything above 8 minutes is kind of a waste of time. So yeah, keep that in mind. But yeah, we are going to try our luck again, going on call here. If I was in a session with a friend, I could also drag a friend in here, they would get an offer to join as well. 8 people might be the same job, it's not too great, but okay, 9 people, we might just go for it. A few things to note here, and that's something that I see b done by randoms quite a lot. First up, it's worth it waiting sometimes, but not indefinitely. And if there is a person who has a really bad internet connection and tries to join and stays stuck in there, berating the host about it does nothing. The host is not able to kick anybody who is in the process of joining, so yeah, don't ask them to. We can't kick those guys. And while somebody is joining, they can't start the job anyway. So I see a lot of hosts getting shit for that, but there's nothing they can do that's on rosters and because they didn't give people the option to get rid of people who are stuck joining. So yeah, usually if you see somebody who is just joining and joining but doesn't really get where it's not worth staying in the session, so I will just go and yeah. Somebody's already telling them to start, the guy does that, so that's okay. When you are doing the quick shop, you are usually just staying on call, so you stay in your session until the host decides to start the job, and then you are getting pulled into the session. So yeah, just so you know. And if you are the only one in there, just back out right away, because suddenly you are the host on call and that doesn't work. So right now I can change a few things. We only have one car, so everything here is cosmetic. I just like to go with a pink and green combination because that just looks very pleasing. Also for this stuff we are getting a free racing suit only to be used in this mission, which doesn't change anything. So yeah, we can now also bet on people since we have some cash in our not in our bank account but in our wallet. I should also mention that we should probably put that into the bank account, but betting doesn't really do much. It's only for minuscule amounts, and the other rates are highly depend on if there are other bets, so I just usually don't bother. So let's just go for a race here. 6 laps. Will take a few minutes, but we'll go through that, and I'll also explain some of the things you should keep an eye out here. So first up, we are in a stock car, but that may not be the same for anybody else. I haven't seen the settings, but it is possible if the guy hosting enabled other vehicles. If you see something that has a window tint or some different kinds of wheels, special colors or so, which isn't really easy to tell with this vehicle, then we know that there are people who are using upgrade cars from just the general speed that I'm able to keep up. It doesn't appear that way. So now to some very important things here. There are some ways to make your car go faster even if you are not able to buy upgrades or something, and that is for example bump boosting. With every compression of the wheels that are of the suspension of the wheels that are transferring power. For example, in this car, since it's rear-wheel drive, I mean the suspension of the rear wheels, you are getting a little speed boost. With cars like this, there are some special properties that I try to block that from happening, but it's still a factor, and you can make yourself go faster by just going over some bumps. Of course, if you go onto the dirt, the car will generally slow down. But just doing some bump boosting can give you one hell of an advantage here, and you should do that if possible. Try to not upset the car like that, but if it's something like this, for example, this is pretty good as long as you keep your grip. And that's also the reason why I'm in second place right now. I actually know the guy in front of me, so yeah, I don't think we are getting that place, but still, this should be quite good. And yeah, we are ranking up for doing some jumps and such. There are some like little achievements that you can get here and there. And that one just got me to rank 2. And yeah, ranking up is always important too. So if you find something that that you like and that is like double or triple money even and reputation, you should definitely do that a lot. Usually, unless it's a really shit thing to begin with, it will be way better than doing just any regular old job. But I will go through some of them later on as well. The thing is, not every activity in this game is for everybody, so sometimes you may just not find anything that's really worth your time, and that sucks, but there are other games to play. And also other activities that will still be okay to do. So, but yeah, I'm now far and away in second place, so I don't expect to get anything else. Here we are in lap 4 out of 6. There's also other things like short shifting. If you hit a bump and you are near an upshift, you can quickly go off your go off a gas for a tiny bit, but I don't usually do that. It's a bit quicker, it lets you shift up earlier, but doesn't. It's not something that I learned, so I can't really do it. There's also other boosts like brake boosting and mid-drive speed boosting, but it's difficult. If you are interested, just search for the terms on YouTube. There are some people who explain it all pretty well. Maybe I can link you over one or the other video down in the description, if I remember. Otherwise, just let me know. And yeah, I'm getting another award for being airborne, which is quite nice. Should maybe even give me another level up. Certainly wouldn't mind that. Actually, these things are giving me so much XP. I did one earlier with my main character, who is at level 888 right now, so far and away above what anybody should really achieve here. I think the last items are handed out at level 120 or level 130, so yeah, I spent a lot of time in this game. Anyways, the main part is that at level 888, winning one of those races with like 8 minutes length, you still get enough XP to get half a level up, so yeah. Just for comparison. Once we are done with this, we should get to level 5 or so, I expect. But we will see. So that's it for this race. We are going to the post race screen in a moment. Just gonna wait for everybody else to finish, and we are getting 20,000 RP and 44,000 cash. That's decent. And I'm at level 9 now, so yeah, I skipped a few levels here. I could now buy the micro SMG, but if I'm just gonna keep up some races here, I can easily get an even higher level. And I think I'm just gonna keep doing that for a while, so yeah, between the videos I'm just gonna do a few of those stops because that needs to happen anyways. So after the first guy, after half a field finished, everybody else gets like a 30-second timer, and after that the entire thing will be stopped, so you'll get a bit of time to finish, but if you don't, well, it's not gonna wait forever for you. Okay, now we have option to like the thing, which will give us 50 RP. Could also dislike, which I think gives 50 RP as well, but not voting, which is also an option, gives us nothing, so yeah. We need every piece of RP which we can get, so I'm happy to just go for upwards on tracks that I may not like that much. So now we can vote for a different kind of job, just in case. Likely going to be the one down below here. Could also go back to free mode, but I would advise you to, if you want to go back to free mode, just press B or whatever button you have that gets you out of the screen. Because that's far faster than just waiting for everybody else to vote. So yeah, now we can also finally see the what the screen looks like for hosting a job. Could invite other players from last job, from a friends list or whatever. And the rest is just for the host. Mount contact races is what we just did, so we are just driving for other people, number of laps, class is set for this, and most important things are custom vehicles, they are off in this case, so everybody is on the same page. Destroy last place and aggregate position are something that people don't usually do. Camera could be locked to first person, and there are usually also the option of slipstream, which is yeah, just like in real racing, if you come to the back of another car and stay there, you will likely get a bit faster because the car in front of you is pushing the air out of your way, and therefore you have less drag for a moment. In GTA it's highly accelerated, and yeah, it makes you go really quick. Can sometimes even cause issues, and then there's also catch up, which is a highly arcadey thing, and it will just slow down the people at the front so everybody else can catch up, even if they are very far behind and have slower cars, so yeah. But that's the basic gist of it. As I mentioned, I'm gonna do a few more of those races, and I'll see you guys next time around. I don't think this will be much of a spectacle, so I'm just gonna level up a bit and get some money. So, till next time, see you guys. Bye bye.